Hi, everybody. Here's a rundown of the day's most important stories so far. In a letter to President Trump and the congressional leadership sent on March 18th, the Puerto Rico Oversight Board expressed its view on potential policy changes that would require increased production of pharmaceuticals and medical products within the United States for national security reasons. Chairman Jose Carrion said the Oversight Board strongly believes that Puerto Rico can be a center of excellence within the nation and play a leading role in the national portfolio of locations where this manufacturing relocates. The physical infrastructure, human capital, and regulatory processes are already established and well-positioned to help assist in the fight against the spread of the COVID-19 coronavirus. The Oversight Board's action was backed by the Puerto Rico Manufacturers Association, which in a separate letter to President Trump, Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, and House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, explaining that bringing manufacturing back to Puerto Rico would be possible with amendments to the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act, which excluded the island from its benefits. By granting credits to companies establishing operations in Puerto Rico, production could be brought back to U.S. soil, the trade group said. This morning, Governor Wanda Vasquez announced the temporary elimination on sales tax on prepared food. The administrative measure passed by Puerto Rico Treasury Secretary Francisco Paredes takes effect tomorrow. It establishes a temporary exemption from the sales tax, which in Puerto Rico is known as the IVU and is 11.5%, on prepared food starting at 12:01 Friday tonight, March 20th, and ending at 11:59 p.m. Sunday, April 19th. Paredes said that in addition to prepared foods, the temporary exemption includes carbonated drinks, bakery products, and candy, but not alcoholic beverages. Meanwhile, Governor Vasquez sent a letter to President Trump and leaders of U.S. Congress urging them to include and treat Puerto Rico the same as to the states in the economic stimulus package currently being drafted in response to the COVID-19 coronavirus pandemic. The letter outlined several government priorities to prepare and provide an effective response to the global outbreak. In the letter, the governor asked that the stimulus package include the language of H.R. 5687, the House-passed emergency supplemental bill designed to provide Puerto Rico funding to address the seismic events that impacted the island beginning in December 2019. The governor reiterated that while the COVID-19 coronavirus pandemic is still ongoing, it doesn't invalidate Puerto Rico's unmet needs from prior major disasters. She requested a stimulus to the domestic supply chain for public health preparedness, pointing out that Puerto Rico can serve as a manufacturing base during these heightened times of concern for public health, much in line with what the Oversight Board presented in its own letter to the president. She also asked for the island to be included in tax provisions that apply nationally to ensure relief available to Puerto Rico's tourism sector and in an increase in funding for Puerto Rico's nutritional assistance program of an additional $1.27 billion. She said this federal funding would ensure food security during the COVID-19 coronavirus global emergency and provide assistance to small businesses and manufacturing sectors affected during this emergency in Puerto Rico. There are two stories developing at the Luis Muñoz Marín International Airport. For one, Governor Vasquez confirmed that the airport has acquired 11 thermographic cameras equipped with infrared systems capable of testing 100% of domestic and international passengers for symptoms of coronavirus. This system, which will be installed in all of the airport's terminals, positions Puerto Rico as the only jurisdiction with an airport with 100% passenger screening, airport officials said. The cameras should be in use tonight, the governor said. At the airport, U.S. Customs and Border Protection announced it will temporarily suspend operations at the Trusted Traveler Program enrollment centers nationwide. That's going to happen from March 19th to at least May 1st. That includes the Global Entry Registration Center in San Juan. Customs decided to do this to minimize exposure of CBP personnel and the public to the COVID-19 coronavirus, the agency said. Meanwhile, the Puerto Rico Small Inn Owners and Tourism Association submitted a letter to the government with 14 ideas to protect employees and the small and mid-sized businesses that comprise the industry. The association, which groups the owners of small hotels known as paradores, suggested improving services at the government's unemployment office to protect displaced employees by ensuring that the Puerto Rico Labor Department has unemployment funds available and adds enough flexibility to quickly provide services to all displaced based employees. In addition, they must automate or seek alternative methods so that beneficiaries can electronically submit the additional information required to apply, obtain, and keep their unemployment benefits, the president of the group, Jesus Ramos, said. Those are the top two suggestions on the list submitted to the governor and lawmakers for their consideration. Thanks for tuning in, and please send your press releases and news tips to news@newsismybusiness.com. And remember, we're still all under quarantine, so please stay home.